Shall I repeat? Listen. Matter forming materialistic conclusions is length. Spirit crisscrossing the matter, influencing, changing the result only to certain level is breadth. Spirit independent of matter, playing and doing its own dance and can create anything from zero to infinity is depth. In depth, spirit matters. In length, spirit does not matter, only matter matters. In breadth, spirit and matter both matters. In depth, only spirit matters, no matter matters. Listen, this is what is dimensions of universe, basic unit dimensions. When Sadashiva describes length, breadth, depth, understand it is not the geometrical LBD. All this inclusive is this LBD. If I have to roughly equate it, length can be equated to your logic, individual logic. Breadth can be equated to your emotion, art, poetry, sculpting. Depth can be equated to your being, where you cognize. Cognize means you cognize somebody is next. Listen carefully. I know it is going above your head. If you just catch this unit, then I'll give you lunch break, and I'll give you, after that I'll answer your questions. I don't know whether I am using enough of words for you to catch. How many of you guys are able to catch? How many of you are not able to catch? Raise your hand. Let me repeat. I'll repeat. Listen. In this Trishul, listen carefully. See here. In this Trishul, this is the length, and this is the depth, and this is the breadth. Am I right? In me, my logical thinking is length, my artistic visualization is breadth, my ability to cognize whatever exists is depth. LBD should not be understood in this level alone, it should be understood in this level. Catching it? In the life, length means all forces which submits itself to the conclusions of logical calculation. Everything which follows certain mathematics. Everything which follows certain mathematics is the length dimension of the universe. All of you are getting? Like a water, if it gathers, it will go towards the slope, means lower area. That is length. Anything which submits itself to the logical conclusion and your ability to calculate and manage is the dimension of length. Anything which can be influenced by the consciousness, spirit, and alters the result, outcome, that dimension is called breadth, where artistic, where the matter does not matter. You can do what you want from zero to infinity means being all alone without anything. Your depth can show you you are king of universe. Being a Rothschild, your depth can make you feel deeply insecure. Independent of the matter means length and breadth, something which is in you which can create anything from zero to infinity is called depth. Cognition. In this Trishul, depth is this. In me, depth is my ability to cognize. Understand? You may be lying down in a beautiful bed in the safe environment, complete security protection, air conditioned room, but in your dream you will be suffocating and you will be running, tigers and snakes will be chasing you. So independent of the length and breadth, your depth is giving you different cognition. How many of you are catching what I am saying? So the depth is your cognition. These three are the unit normal human mind understands in your day-to-day life. So I'll stop with it and give you lunch break. When you come back, I'll explain time and space. Now you guys, I wanted you to chew this also along with your food. See, once more I'll repeat. Length of this Trishul, this. Breadth of this Trishul, this. Depth of this Trishul, this. Length of you is logic. Breadth of you is art, emotion. Depth of you is your cognition. Length of the universe is anything which submits itself to a mathematical calculation. 100 plus 100 is 200. If you can come to a conclusion with your maths, all those forces are called length. If something which you can influence and alter, all those forces called breadth. There is something independent of that you can just generate and live. That dimension is called depth in the universe. The spirit is the depth of the universe, where independent of this, that can generate anything. Like how Vishwamitra created Trishanku Surga. That's consciousness, cognition. He was able to create a new loka for Trishanku. That powerful consciousness. So, length of the Trishul, length of you, length of the universe. Breadth of the Trishul, breadth of you, breadth of the universe. Depth of the Trishul, depth of you, depth of the universe. How many of you are catching? Depth of the Trishul is this. Depth of you is your ability to dream bad dreams even when you are in the great bungalow, or ability to have a good dreams even while you are in the street platform. That is your depth. Depth of the universe is Vishwamitra able to create one swarga for Trishanku. The force of Vishwamitra which he had, independent of the length and breadth of the universe, out of his sheer will which he is able to manifest, that is the depth of the universe. If he can dream heaven for himself, it is depth of Vishwamitra. If he can manifest a dream for somebody else, he is even manipulating the depth of the universe. I think it'll take, just chew these ideas along with food.
I wanted all of you to talk about these ideas while you are eating with your friends. Come back with questions. Then I think literally I am opening up different dimensions to you. This understanding will change the way you cognize you. I guarantee you. This will be such a strong, rude awakening. You will never go back to sleep without by forgetting this understanding anymore. When you come back, after Vakyarth Sadas with this length, breadth, depth definitions, I'll introduce time and space. Quickly grab your plate, have Vakyarth Sadas along with your eating, come back. Let's gather.